As of Asset Framework 2016, we can capture child event frames with the analysis service. Child event frames are useful when you need to send escalating notifications or perform in-depth analyses for past events. To create the parent-child event frame hierarchy, we'll utilize multiple start triggers and differing severities. For example, as a process engineer, I know when my temperature in my press reaches a threshold, I'm in the heating phase. I would like to capture every time I'm heating my equipment so I can optimize the process. Additionally, I know that if my process gets too hot, something is wrong. I would like to highlight the times that my asset may be overheated. In PI System Explorer, I'm concerned with my Houston Press 5, specifically the internal temperature. To begin capturing my event frames, I'll go to the Analyses tab. I'll create a new analysis, and I can give it a name. Next, I will select my analysis type. In this case, it will be event frame generation. After I select event frame generation, the event frame template dropdown will appear. This was created earlier, and it shows the different attributes that I would like to capture for each event frame created. In my case, I created one called process. Now I'm ready to create my start triggers. The first start trigger I'll make is when my process goes into the heating phase. In that case, it's when the process goes above 36 degrees. Because the value that I care about is an attribute, I'll enclose it in single quotes. This start trigger is almost complete. I will give it a severity of information because this describes my heating phase. To create my second start trigger, I'll click on the bottom, add a new start trigger. This start trigger will show when my asset has entered an overheating phase. In my case, it's when the internal temperature is over 53 degrees Celsius. For severity here, I will mark it as critical, as this will disturb my process and may ruin the final result. It is important to note that I do not need an end trigger in this situation. Once all of my start triggers are no longer true, which means that my process goes below 36 degrees, my event frame will close. Additionally, it's worth noting that my start triggers do not need to be based off the same variable. I can use different tags values and different process values in order to control how my event frames and child event frames will ultimately be created. The last piece is looking at how my event frame is scheduled. I will leave this scheduled as event triggered. That means any time that my internal temperature updates, I will check to see if I need to enter the event frame. To make this event frame active, I will need to check in my changes. Once checked in, I will wait to see the green check mark appear next to my heating process. Now that I have the green check mark, I know that I'm collecting data and I'll create events if my process goes above 36 degrees and a critical event if it goes above 53. Let's see how the events were created as I take a look at my process. I will begin by marking the two thresholds that create both information and critical child event frames. We can see that once the process went above 36 degrees, the yellow line, I'm creating an information child event. Once it crosses the red line, we can see that I'm creating a critical child event frame. When it drops down below the red line, I'll create another information child event frame. It goes above the red line to create a critical event frame, and it finishes with creating one last information event frame. All of this is contained in the parent event frame. Let's take a look at PI System Explorer and how we can view our event frames. To view my event frames, I will go on the left to the Event Frames tab. I can right-click and do a new search. And I will take a look for the specific event frame that I was showing in my process before. I'll select the event frame template, and my element was the Houston Press 5. I'll make sure to uncheck all descendants. All descendants will treat child event frames as if they were parents. In this case, I only want to search for the parent event frame. At the top right, I'll hit search. And let's take a look for our event frame. As you see here, we started the same way that we expected. We had an information event frame, later a critical event frame, followed by information, critical, and lastly information before the process returned below 36 degrees and exited the heating phase. If I take a look at the severity, that matches up completely. It's important to note that the severity of the parent event frame will always be the highest severity of any of its children. Even though we started and ended with information event frames, the severity is marked as critical because we had at least one instance of a critical event. Let's take a look at how the effective trigger is determined to see which child events we will create. The effective trigger is what will determine which child event is created. The highest severity that is true will always be the effective trigger. If you have the same severity for multiple start triggers, then the first that appears in the list that is true at the time will be the effective trigger. Let's look at a few scenarios. In the process example that I showed before, we went from information to critical to begin our event frame. This is the situation here. However, the low severity trigger actually overlaps the high severity. The parent event includes the total time that any of the start triggers were active. The child events that are created are based off the highest severity trigger because that becomes the effective trigger once it is true. Let's see the example of going from high to low. Again, the resulting child events follow the highest severity trigger because that continues to be our effective trigger. In the case that a low severity trigger is in the span of a high severity trigger, we do not create the parent-child event frame hierarchy. This only creates one event frame. In this last example, we see when we have the same severity. In this case, only when the effective trigger changes is when we create a different child event. By using multiple start triggers with differing severities, we were able to create the parent-child event frame hierarchy that we desired to have a better insight into our process. And now, if we ever want to do more analysis later on, we have the exact times that our process deviated or overheated. We also explored the different behaviors the effective trigger will take, and that determines your child event frames.